the break of night, and the pink sky's waving goodbye. You come out the break of night, leaving no traces around. She's trying to free, she's trying to free her reckless heart. She's trying to be as light, as light as the breeze. The queen of art, frowning.
Jay Shrek, I tell you what, we're at an epic location today. We're at the thing. How incredible is this place? This is only a stop on the journey, so we can't stop to see the thing. But, John, the thing. Oh, look, you got...
She's in there now. She's buying something.
She's buying the thing?
Yeah, she's got a shirt with her name on it.
You can't help it. We're not going to watch and see the thing today, but what we're going to do is I'm going to give you a little sign here that we can put up. The thing entrance. The thing. Tell you what, the thing is an incredible place. So we're going to shoot a little bit right here. So look on there. Once you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, no matter how improbable, must be the truth. Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. What'd you get, Maria?
I got a fox.
Look at the thing. Look at that thing there. Look at that. You know, we'll have to wait till another journey to see the thing. But I'm telling you what, when you're out here in southern Arizona, you must come see the thing, because I tell you what, the thing is a pretty incredible place to be. But that's not where we're going today. We are going on the hunt for a character in southwestern lore called Blackjack. Blackjack Ketchum. And I can't wait. I'm so stoked today. Unbelievable. So let's get back in the truck and get on this epic adventure. Jay Shrek, I tell you what a day we've had. We've been pretty much everywhere today. The only problem is everywhere we've went is no trespassing. Our road closed. Or we went to go find out and I wanted to match up where Geronimo actually surrendered, the location, not the concrete pillar, because that's not where he really surrendered. And so we went there and it's a private road. We tried to get to another location. It was also a private road. And it was like, you know, we don't want to trespass. I mean, that's not part of what we do. But my gosh, you talk about frustrating. So we're making our loop. We're in southern Arizona. And John had a place that him and Maria had came, and they do a lot of birding. And so we came to a place that is called Portal, Arizona. And this is where the birders come from all over the world in this
this area. And I look at this. Now, the added bonus today is this, is a lot of native cultures were here as well. So we're looking for two pictographs that are pretty distinctive. And we know there's more, but these are two that we're on the hunt of today. And we're gonna take a look up through these trails to see if we can't find it. One we've got kind of a bead on, the other we're not really sure. We're gonna come through here, we're gonna take a look. Now, one thing, if you're into poison ivy, John's pointed out that there's poison ivy everywhere. And, you know, I'm not a poison ivy guy. I'm about as allergic to poison ivy as you possibly can get. So I'm a little freaked out about that. I'd rather deal with three rattlesnakes and a coral snake than poison ivy. How crazy is that? But we're gonna come up to this rock structure right up here and take a look. You can tell this is a pretty well-worn path. So it's probably whatever's up here is not super secret. But you can kind of see how these areas are really incredible. Look at this cool rock outcropping right here. Oh, looky there. Let's see, we do have some markings on the walls up here, don't we? Oh, look here. That's, you know, you can tell that this was probably a pretty incredible structure at one time. As you go through here, you can see that this rock shelter had been used for hundreds and hundreds of years. Now, there's supposed to be some very spectacular pictographs up here in this location because the natives were all over this area. Well, you know, there wasn't a lot here, but you know what? You can definitely tell that that they definitely had some work on these walls at one time. I'll tell you what, look out here. This is a beautiful location. Pretty incredible. Now, we're looking for a petroglyph today that's pretty elusive. It's a pictograph. So it's actually been painted. And we know just by seeing these structures here that we know they're out here. We know there's a lot. So I'm not sure exactly where, as we go through here, look how incredible this still is. How incredible this is. You've got these trails that go through and up in here. Tell you what, you know, some days when you do this, you have all these plans and you spend all this time and you've got all these trails. And we had a trail on Google Earth and to try to get into a location by not crossing private property, and failed miserably after driving 175 miles. It's just part of doing this, you know. It's frustrating. I'm not gonna say it's not, but that is. Every once in a while, you run into this. So we're on a third or fourth location without getting in. So, you know, that does happen. So don't get frustrated. Just realize that, you know, on occasion, you know, the best made plans are gonna run afoul. So. All you can do is try to figure out what you're going to do. But I'm going to tell you what. This is a beautiful... It reminds me kind of a Sedona that... with no people. As crazy as that sounds. I think I might even have said that once. But how crazy is that? That this place is just beautiful. I don't think there's... hell, there's not... You don't even need a trail. That's just it.
I think that's a trail, I'm not sure.
Either way.
I don't see any poison ivy.
You know the stuff, I don't even know it and I'm alert.
I know it, and it's got a three-leaf thing, but these are not. And they also have, some are shiny and some are not, but I don't see any.
You know what we're doing is we're walking this ridge line, because along this ridge line we found these cave shelters, and we're going up right now to see what's up here and see what could be underneath. And you know, the first thing is, one thing, if you find anything, you know at least that you've got, you know, you've got ancients in these areas. So now everything's possible at this point. So, you know, you check all these rock croppings like this just to see what's up here. And they'll give you an idea if you've got anything in here. Looks like we got something up here. Yeah. They're not super distinctive. Here you've got definitely work here. Right there. Right here. Along here. Not every one of them is going to be super exciting, but what it does, like I said, it tells you that you have ancients in this vicinity. So now every time you see some type of rock cropping or shelter, you need to at least look at it, because you potentially are going to see that they were up and down this creek bed. They were up a little higher. Creek bed's right down here. What a beautiful day, man. Look at this place. You know, finding any type of pictograss is more of a, you know, just a bonus to a beautiful day and a beautiful location. You know, they've lost their color through time and the design, but you know they're definitely here. There's a piece right here. That looks exactly like it was worked out right here. Not sure positively, but you know, anytime I see any of them, it's an exciting deal. So, you know, we saw two rock shelters. We found two sets of pictographs so far, and man, that's a good day. Now, there's an elusive pictograph we're looking for that is not, you don't see a lot. I have seen a picture, so this wouldn't be the first picture of it, but there is an elusive, and this, now this is a lot of stuff we've been able to pop right off of the the road. But the next one's going to be up in that, to give you kind of an idea what we're looking at right there. So we're going to have a hike coming up this cliff wall, and then it should get exciting. I'm ready to go though. I'm ready to do this. I'm ready to get it going. You know, I've just been informed that we are in the area of a quetzal. I don't even know what the hell a quetzal is, but we're close to one. So, they say it meows like a cat. So, if I hear a cat, I will know that's a quetzal. The bird people are actually pretty damn excited about this bird, but I don't know shit about nothing. There's a lady right there. It's a quetzal. What the hell is a quetzal? I don't even know. I don't want to ruin these people. We're looking for pictographs, but they're looking for quetzals. Look at that. Look at that peak right there. Is that gorgeous or what? You know, it's kind of funny, and everybody's into something different. The cool thing about what we do is a lot of times John can be looking at, you know, stuff he likes, and Maria. And it's all in the same area, right? So we can see these pictographs and we can see these birds. But look at that's, they're on the hunt. If you've never seen birders, look at there. Deer or cars all over. They're just looking at me. I'm like, my God. I'm like, oh dear. And that's where I want to get to. That's where we're heading up there. Now that everybody's had a lot of chance to look at it, I'm going to get up behind John and I'm going to see if I can't get the Quetzal on video. Saying, hey, is there any hot chicks coming around? You know, we've seen birds and coming down here, I mean, it's incredible just to see the wildlife, and they really don't seem to really care. I mean, we've come across what I would consider to be one herd. And you know, I don't know what a herd of deers is, but there was 20-25. Now look at these little guys here. And they're just by the road, and I mean, they're not like really getting freaked out. But look at this, look at these little guys. Don't seem to really care. You know, I guess they know when they're in a protected area, because look at that. I mean, you're getting right up on them. They don't seem to care. Now I'm tempted to see how close I can get. They don't care. Look at that. They moved a little, but not a lot. Look at that little baby. Hello, little baby. Hello, little baby. Thought I saw another little baby over there. I mean, wow. I kind of feel like, what was Jim Carrey's movie, Pet Detective? I kind of feel like the pet detective. Holy Christ. Rare birds that everybody's been waiting days, week pulled up, and we see them. And how crazy is that? That's like unbelievable. So we're gonna get up this mountain now that we've had our share of baby animals and birds, and we're gonna get up this area and see if we can't find a pictograph that is spectacular. It's a beautiful day.
You saw a rare bird today, Mr. Stewart.
My only bird ever was a rare bird.
Very rare in Arizona.
Hear that? I'm a birder, I think. Like I said, instead of flipping the bird or getting it flipped, what an awesome day today was so far. Well, it was. It's not over yet. I'm going to say there's not a lot of options on going up here. Good sign there. So that's going to be an interesting journey. So looks like there's another creek up here that wise in that we might be able to take back up and see if we find another trail up in here. Well, we've run on a trail through here, and I don't know where it goes because we're not going up that way, that's for sure. I don't see any way. You know, it goes back still to that other side, looked like a better way. We're not climbing up this wall, though. It's straight up.
You're just being nice to us because you can.
I don't think I'd want to. It's going to be bad enough over here. Yeah, you saw your thing. What we're going to do is, it looked like from the road there was a way to get up and around this, because I'm telling you what, that's straight up. Now there might be a trail through here. That kind of looks like a trail. I think any of these that we tick, we can go up in here. But look what, you know, all the work just to try to find the right trail. You know, I mean, it's a lot of work trying to figure out the right trail. Get us up and over. This might not have been the best way. John's way may actually be a lot better. That's steep as shit right there. And you sure wouldn't want to come down this way. Okay, my shoes didn't stick. as good as I wanted them to. Right there. I don't like this moss. I don't like it at all. Look at that. Holy crap. Yeah, I mean, I'm going up pretty quick, but it's a bitch. Did you see a trail over there at all? Oh, and I can already see where it's chipping off. Get up here a couple more, and I'm not gonna waste any time. I'm gonna get moving. Sometimes speed is good. I don't see any trails. Tell you what, this is a tough son of a bitch. I mean, it gets flatter up there where it's not gonna be as bad for me, but they still gotta get up here. But I don't even know if you can get through it from there. You know, there might be a whole lot easier way, but I haven't found it. Man. Huffing and puffing going on today. That sucks when something's only a tenth or 2/10. But the problem with that 2/10 is, it's like that. So I'm gonna get up in here, try to get to this ledge right there. See that ledge? Kind of figure out what my game plan is once I get there. You know, a lot of people are gonna come up here. Not a lot of people can. Take a break right here. Look at that. Gonna be a mother coming down. I'm gonna tell you that already. It's gonna be tough. Be tough coming down. I wonder if that's a trail over there. I know I don't like this rock. Let's see. There's a trail there. Don't want to go down too far. That looks easier than this. Here's a key right there. That looks pretty hairy getting in though. Holy crap. See if I can't get up here and get a look. Well, I'm gonna try and see if these rocks here split. If they don't split, I don't know what I'm gonna do. One cave's over in this direction. But I don't know where. If we can't split this, I don't know what we're gonna do. What a tough deal. Whew. Man, ain't nothing easy about this. Climb. Man. same for the weak of heart, I'll tell you that. This view though, man. Tell you what, I'm gonna be going at slow motion coming down this. We're not gonna be jacking around coming down. We're gonna be paying attention. For sure. Now that might put us in a bind right there. You know, the deal with this is, boy, you get off on the wrong track and sure ain't easy. Well, it looks like I'm going to have to make one of them tough calls again. I hate doing it, but I got up to here to see how hard this was going to be. I got to go up there. That's straight up. No ropes. Is that another way there? That's the trail, but... You know, by myself, I'm honestly not feeling it, you know? So, well, how frustrating is this? You know what, there's a point where you gotta be smart and not feeling it. Not feeling that, man, that looks like a trail right there. But I'm telling you what, you know, man, you hate making these decisions, but sometimes you got to make them. That this isn't the day to solo this up here. And man, I'm bummed. You know, I made this call one other time, and I still know that that was the best choice. And so I'm going to do it again, because even what I've climbed, I'm having difficulty getting down. I'm not saying that there's not a better trail somewhere, but this ain't it. You know, the reality is this. You know, you never quit, but you might take a chance on doing it a different day. You know, it's getting a little hairy up here. Not a little hairy. It's getting real hairy. So, I'm going to make the choice. Pull down, you know, today was a total bust all the way around. You know, couldn't get in anywhere. This was kind of my last ditch effort to try to find something. And man, it didn't work out today. But, you know, if there is one lesson, you know, the lesson is live to fight another day. Well, I know that that wasn't the route. Or it wasn't the route by myself, I'll put it that way. It was not the route by myself. Damn it, look what we saw today. Well, that goes to show you right there what can happen. Well, you know, you got a certain amount of time, or I do, that you're on your top of your game, and then when you start to get tired, you're off your game, and you fall, and here I am, I'm already decided I'm not gonna fight this, I'm gonna go ahead and go down, and what happens, you know, I fall over here, you know, so it happens. I might go that way a little bit and see if that ridge over there is as good as I thought it was. I really believe my initial thought was accurate, and that was to find a more flat area over here where I tell you what, it's even tough over here. I don't like this at all. That sucked. I'll tell you what, a lot of miles and a lot of money for nothing today. You know, we tried the first cave, double secret cave. Couldn't get him. Tried to get Geronimo's actual surrender site. Road's blocked off. Second cave to go in. Road's blocked off. This cave here, just today it was too tough. Today it was too much today. By myself. And then, you know, I didn't have a walkie-talkie, and I can't believe we forgot to put the walkie-talkie on, but we did. I felt a lot more comfortable, but still, it got hairy. If you'll see, hell, I fell on the way down. I hadn't even, you know, I was still a long way from the top where I had to go. This wasn't the day today. And, you know, you just keep coming back at it, you know. You don't quit, but you regroup, you figure out what you did wrong, where you went wrong, and you go at it another day. But that was a monster today. This is a monster right here. Well, sorry to let you guys down today, but man, we had a beautiful day of gorgeous weather. We saw a bird, we saw deers. We saw kind of some pictographs, but not great ones, but the elusive one that we were hunting, just have to get it in another day. So that's all you can do. Well, I appreciate you coming along with me. Regardless, we give it hell today. Only been a couple times we haven't found what we wanted. I know it was there. Today I couldn't get to it. I am gonna look and see if there was a areas that I could have maybe went up. I know I took the wrong route, but I only had one route in me. So, and I couldn't get over there I wanted to get once I committed to that cliff, it was no good. No muy, no muy bueno. So, hell, we'll give it hell again the next time. Jay Schreck, Black Flag Expeditions. We have a live show every Tuesday at 7 p.m. That is Phoenix time. So California, you're gonna be an hour early. East Coast, you're going to be 2 hours later, so 6 and 9, respectively. So, come on, we'll see you, and we'll talk about today's adventure a little bit. Boy, the last 4 or 5, I have run into no trespassing, and one thing I don't like we do not like to trespass. But man, it seems like everything's closed, and that's just the way it went today. So, stay positive, stay good. Adios, my friends. I'll see you again. You know, I got some birds up there and I don't want to piss them off. But I tell you what, when I get like this, I'm almost angry at myself. Because, you know, there's always a way up there and there's always a way that you can get up there. It's just a matter of figuring out how to do it. And I'm really upset with myself that I didn't find a better way up there. Because, you know, it's there. And again, I should have taken the route that went over to the, would have been the north. I should have taken the north route. And I don't know why I didn't do it. Because it was absolutely the way that it should have went. You know, instead of getting up there on those steep ledges and not being able to see, you know, what we should have done was we should have salted the other side of the mountain and made the climb over there. But we didn't make the climb because I got into a cliff face up there that was a little steeper than I wanted to do by myself today. If I'd have had someone else and maybe ropes, we definitely would have given that a shot. The little baby, let's see how close we can get to that little baby. There he is. Look at that pretty guy. Look at that. I don't think the bird people are social distancing. I don't think they're social distancing. I think they're grouping together. I don't think that's social distancing. So what is the rule of social distancing? Is that you can't be around? They're a flock. They're on your cat. They got it. They saw my bird. Did they see my bird?
Huh?
They see my bird?
Yeah, they see the bird. They're fucking crazy, right? They just see a piece of red way back in there. They see.
Oh, they can't see it like we did.
No. No, they'd be fucking painted.
Why don't you go show him a picture, somebody a picture, just so I can see him freak out. Show the way back, lady.
Break a night, the pink skies waving goodbye. She come out to break a night, leaving no traces around. She's trying to free her reckless heart.